the man, the myth, the interstellar guru himself, the one and only Avi Loeb. I couldn't think of anything to say there, if you couldn't tell. I wasn't being dramatic. This is interesting. Harvard's Avi Loeb on 3I Atlas, the interstellar object shows mysterious non-gravitational acceleration and no tail. It just gets weirder and weirder. The interstellar object 3I Atlas recently captured the attention of scientists worldwide after showing non-gravitational acceleration as it passed near the sun. Behavior suggesting it may not be behaving like a typical comet or asteroid. And it also doesn't seem to have a cometary tail. In an interview with NBC News with Gotti Shorts, Harvard astrophysicist Avi Loeb discussed the implications of these findings, connecting them to his ongoing work with the Galileo Project. So let's go ahead and watch that clip with Gotti Shorts. This is pretty interesting. And we'll hear more about the tail, the acceleration, and things just keep getting weirder. Mystery deepens with 3I Atlas. Give this a watch.
Professor, the last time we spoke, which was like the day before yesterday, you were saying that when it went behind the sun, the natural explanation for the non-gravitational acceleration and the thrust might be because it burned off a bunch of chemicals or something, and that was giving it the thrust to the tune of like 13%, and we would see a humongous tail maybe. What is going on?
Yeah, that's very surprising because there should have been a very massive cloud of gas and dust around it based on what we know about comets. In fact, we see other comets in the solar system that have a beautiful tail away from the sun. Behind them, Lemon is an excellent example. But in our case of 3I Atlas, it looks like a fuzzy ball of light. Even after it passed through perihelion, it was heated by 770 watts per square meter. We know that the previous plume of gas was mostly carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide ices can sublimate at a much lower temperature than water ice. So we should have seen it break up, or at the very least disintegrate, to a very dense and massive cloud of gas and dust that is pushed away from the sun by the solar radiation and the solar wind. But we don't see that. So the question is, what's going on? One possibility is that what evaporates from it are fragments of ice, and they get vaporized by sunlight before they have a chance to turn around and show up as a plume of glow behind it, away from the sun. That's one possible interpretation, but otherwise I just don't know what to make of it. There was also a blue color that was noticed just a few days ago, and also in addition to that, it became brighter by a factor of five. So what I'm saying is, you know, there are things we don't fully understand about this object. That's what makes it exciting. And I think all of us will wait for the data that will come in the coming weeks, and especially on December 19th, when it comes closest to Earth. That's 6 days before Christmas. And let's hope we don't get unwanted gifts for our holidays.
Or at least maybe those gifts will be nice and friendly and wonderful and help us figure the universe out. We'll see. Avi, you do not seem surprised here. I know that we've been asking you about this, and we were all expecting to see a tail, and we asked you for a natural, plausible explanation. You gave us that one, and now we're seeing no tail. Like, what do you think it is?
I don't know. I think... you know, it's like a blind date with an interstellar object that came from an environment that is alien to us. And I think the key question is whether it's natural or technological. The secondary question, if it's natural, what kind of an environment did it come from? Mm-hmm. It must be a common environment that produces large packages delivered to our mailbox. And we just need to find out the sender. Either way, it's thrilling. And it's really the reason why science is worthwhile doing, because we can gain new knowledge. And that goes against the tendency of experts to pretend to be the adults in the room that know the answer in advance. Well, guess what? This object is telling the experts, think twice.
I love that. Think twice. Also, a blind date with an interstellar object. Amazing. Interesting. Interesting stuff. The tail seems to be missing, the acceleration, the maneuvers, all crazy. It's going to be coming back, guys. It's going to be coming back our way. So hopefully we'll get the clearest images yet. Now, the big thing right now, the contention is that NASA actually has very clear images of this thing, but they're not releasing them to the public right now. And that is because there's a government shutdown in the United States again. And, you know, that includes NASA. So while they are not working, they are not, you know, able to release these images, which sounds a little ridiculous. But, you know, these things have to go through channels, bureaucracy, all that stuff before they can be released to the public. So if no one's there to work and to do those things, then, you know, we're not going to see those images. It sucks. A little bit more here. Despite ongoing disruptions from the U.S. government shutdown, NASA officials are set to brief a congressperson on this. Yep, you guessed it. The one, the only, Anna Paulina Luna. They're going to brief her this upcoming Wednesday regarding 3I Atlas, following her formal request for the release of new imagery and data. Luna's team confirmed this meeting. A government source told Defense Scoop that NASA continues to monitor the object and plans to share its findings publicly once the shutdown ends. The discussion marks the first official engagement between NASA and Congress about 3I Atlas, reflecting growing political and scientific interest in understanding the rare visitor's origins and implications. And also, the meeting follows mounting public pressure and speculation surrounding 3I Atlas. NASA's engagement with Luna signals a broader recognition of the need for interagency cooperation. So basically, either way, speculation continues to grow, and it seems to only be getting worse. The fact that these images aren't being released, people are now getting more and more conspiratorial with their thinking. Like, why isn't NASA releasing these? Why? What is it they don't want us to see and stuff like that? And honestly, the only scientists we're really hearing from right now about any of this is Avi Loeb. And the fact that he brought forward these very sort of broad, bold claims that it could be a alien ship or a mothership or whatever, that's all people are talking about. And to Avi's credit, I will give him this. He said it is a very, very astronomically minute chance that it's an alien mothership. But of course, that is what everyone is running with. But he has made it very clear in later interviews and whatnot that he does, you know, believe that this is most likely a comet, but is highly anomalous. And it's not acting like any comet we've ever seen for very good reason. And those reasons I actually want to share with you guys now. Another scientist who was recently interviewed about this was Michio Kaku. Finally, you know, a voice of reason in all of this. And he was on News Nation. And he is trying to kind of calm the conspiratorial nerves when it comes to 3I Atlas and you know, tell us what it really is. Basically. So I'm going to go ahead and play that Michio Kaku video.
With the new images of 3I Atlas, not from our own NASA, we are still waiting on those. These ones are out of Spain. Some are noting it looks like this object has lost its tail after passing the sun. What's your take here? And if there's no tail, does that mean this is indeed not a comet?
Well, I have my own point of view on this. And that is that this is a very old object, perhaps 7 billion years old. And in 7 billion years, there's been a plenty of time to accumulate garbage. That's why, for example, the nickel content of the comet is off scale. Its chemical composition is not what an ordinary comet should be. And that, I think, is because over 7 billion years, it's had plenty of time to accumulate different gases, different elements, different kinds of environments that it goes into. And I think that explains a lot of the mystery behind the comet. And everyone's talking about it. I was on the airplane the other day and overheard some people talking over my shoulder. And sure enough, they were talking about the comet too.
Did you pop your head over the seat and say, hi, I'm Dr. Michio Kaku, one of the foremost experts on this. And this is my opinion.
No, I did not say that, but I would gladly have given them my opinion.
Yeah.
It is a 7 billion year old comet. And that's why it's different. It's different from other comets. Comets in our solar system, for example, are maybe only 3 to 4 billion years old. This one is a very old comet, and as a consequence, it has plenty of time to accumulate garbage, and that's one of the characteristics of this comet. It has nickel, iron content, which is different from the average comet.
You know, we're still waiting on an updated image of this object from NASA. We see Representative Ana Paulina Luna sharing this week that it will not be shared until the government is reopened. Do you make anything of this? Is NASA hiding something here?
Sounds like it, right? I mean, what have they got to lose? I mean, it's only a sheet of paper. I mean, it's not like a top secret thing you put in a safe. It's just a sheet of paper. So what have they got to lose by announcing that they have this information? Because it fosters more and more speculation. And at a certain point, it becomes counterproductive.
You've been closely monitoring 3I Atlas for months now. I'm tracking these anomalies, some bizarre behavior. What are the odds that we're dealing with something not just old, but something that's extraterrestrial in nature?
I think it's non-zero, but it's very small. So far, it looks like an ordinary comet. It behaves like an ordinary comet. And except for these a few anomalies, it does act like an ordinary comet. And so I think it's really pointless to preserve secrets to keep things away from the American public. The public want to know.
Avi Loeb, meanwhile, out of Harvard, believes that 3I Atlas may be revving its engine. Any thoughts on that?
Well, there's a possibility. You have to put probabilities with regards to all the speculation. Avi Loeb was very careful later on to say that the probability of his speculations are quite low. And so we have to put this into perspective that these are guesses. And as a consequence, they're not 100%.
There you go. It's so good to hear another scientist like talk about Avi Loeb's theories. So, I mean, he tends to agree. We don't know. And the lack of transparency, per se, by NASA is going to only make that worse. So, But Michio is pretty damn sure it's a comet. It seems like Avi Loeb is slowly putting that white flag up and saying, yeah, it's probably a comet. But again, like, it's going to be zipping back our way. Hopefully, we'll get some more clear images. And hopefully, once the government shutdown is over, NASA will release those images to the public as well. But we got some pretty darn good ones from Spain, like they said, as well. So that's cool. We'll see. The mystery of 3I Atlas is not over, guys. So we will continue to follow this story and follow this object as it makes its way out of our galaxy in the very near future. December 19th, keep that date in mind. December 19th, 3I Atlas will be closest to Earth, and hopefully we'll get our clearest images yet. It will be an interesting Christmas, to say the least. What a gift.